Hi guys, Scorder here, and welcome back to the Bus Simulator 16 Career Mode playthrough. Now, the first thing you possibly notice is the music's turned off. There's a very good reason for that. YouTube. Copyright claims on the music in the video, which I then had to dispute and then got released. Absurd as it is, we all know what YouTube copyright system is currently like. I managed to get the disputes overruled, and then the first two videos went out. But in the third video, I thought, you know what? I'm just going to turn the menu music off. So I apologize in advance. We can't listen to some nice music because YouTube. Anyway, if you remember where we got up to level 6, or reputation level 6, and we just unlocked this district up here. And we have our new objectives, which are to have a route with at least 2 bus stops in each unlocked district and drive it at least once. So we need to create a route here that's going to have 2 stops here and 2 stops here. Then we're going to have to drive it. So that's the first thing. Then we need to reach reputation level 7. Well, we'll do that by driving. Have at least 3 different routes you and your drivers drove last week. Okay, now we only currently have 2 routes and we only have 1 driver. We have 249,000 in the bank, which is a lot of money, which is cool, because a bus only costs, like, what, 89,000? Oh, incidentally, by the way, I know for a fact that there are MAM buses in this. You unlock them later at a high level, but as well as these SAS buses, you unlock MANs, and they're rather nice, so we'll get to that later, hopefully. But right now, I'm thinking, hey, look how much money we've got. We probably need another driver. In order to do that, though, we're going to need to create some more routes. So I was kind of thinking about how we might do this. It says, have all the bus stops be part of your routes driven by your drivers last week. Right, so there's a kind of a clue here. I think what we should do is we should create a route which picks up the one of the requirements, which is to take 2 stops here and 2 stops here. And I was looking at the map and I was thinking, you know what, if we go via kind of West Hill Drive, St. Andrew's Church, Village Street, so we take that little loop, that inner loop there, and then we come down here, Garden Lane, Church Street, Genetian, and loop through Clover Drive. So we pick up a kind of a very inner circuit between the two, all right? And then all you've got to do is pick up all the remaining bus stops. So then we can have another route which goes like Lavender Drive, Rake, Crowns, like this, all the way back to St. Paul's Church. So just a route there that creates, that picks up the remaining bus stops. And the same thing up here. We'll try and create a route that that picks up the remaining bus stops. However, it's a little bit harder here because we've got these little one-way systems to contend with. So it's a little bit annoying. Once we've done that, we'll then have 3 routes. And then we'll buy another driver. So the first thing to do, I think, is probably modify this route here, this sort of pink one. And we'll use the pink one to create the branching route between these two districts. So let's go ahead and do that. That is going to be that one there. So what we have to do is click on the pencil, and the route editor is slightly annoying because it doesn't let us just arbitrarily remove stops out of it. We have to sort of delete them in reverse order, which is a bit of a pain. So in actual fact, what we're going to end up doing here, because we don't want St. Paul's Church, so if we kind of remove that one and then remove Church West, that's pretty much what we're looking for. On this side, we just need to add Genetian Street, but we want to add more stops here. So how are we going to do that? Because if we click on it, you can see what's going to happen. It's going to go 4 and then 5. So we need to undo everything here like that. So we start at Clover Drive, West Hill, St. Andrews, Village Street. That's the 2. We don't need to stop here. Then we'll go, but we're going to do it anyway because we don't want to miss any stops out. Bacara Street, Garden Lane. Then we'll have Church Street, Genetian. We'll cut right across back to Clover Drive. So that'll be it. That's the circuit right there. And then it goes back to Clover Drive. So we'll save that. It'll say, the route needs to be driven. Do you want to drive it now? We'll say no for now. Now, our other driver is... this is where it's a bit tricky because our other driver, of course, if we go and edit the other route, he then won't be able to drive that at all, which is a bit annoying. So in actual fact, I'm going to have to go and drive it just to make it active, then get him driving this one so I can then free to edit that one. And then finally, after we've activated that one, we can then buy a new bus and driver, get him on this, and create the third and final route. So it's a bit tedious, but that's the way it has to be done because you have to drive a route before you assign an AI to it. So let's get on and drive this route. Yeah, here we go. Oh, the lack of track IR. Apparently, track IR guys have got hold of the developers of this game, and essentially said to them, you know what, we can help you to get Track IR into this game, which which I think is a wonderful thing. I really hope they do that, because I would love to be able to look around. Ah, Bus Simulator, how I've missed your wonderful AI people. This is perhaps the best part of this game, I think. Its strength lies in the passengers. Not in the bus physics, certainly, but in the interaction you get with the passengers, I think it's pretty decent. Come on. There we go. Okay. Now, if you press the T key, it kind of puts in a speed limiter. So you shouldn't see us breaking any speed limits. Also, I need to mention the last video. Last two videos you might have saw, you saw some like texture popping. That wasn't actually the game, I don't think. I've since reinstalled to Windows 10, and those issues have gone away. But that was a pre-release version, so it may have been texture popping from a pre-release. Okay. Clover Drive. Hello.
Good day. Regular single trip, please.
Regular latte coming up. Regular trip. Okay. So let's give you 80 and a 2. And you're done.
Thank you, dear.
Uh-oh. Bus is rolling. Bus is rolling. I forgot to press a button. That's the engine button. Something's blocking the door. Are you serious? Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. Would you mind moving? Okay.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't notice.
It's okay. You just make the bus late. It's not a problem. There we go. We're on our way. I forgot to put the parking brake. Well, not really the parking brake. Left behind? I didn't... Oh. Wait. How many doors does this thing have? Not that button. How many doors does this thing actually have? I thought we had the two-door version. I'm guessing I picked the three-door. My bad. Marta Market. What a great name. Oops, sorry, bro. Could have actually wiped him out then if I wasn't careful. And I'll also make it Neil.
Hello. Can you help me with a ticket?
Wait a minute, what do you want? Senior, single trip, 140, oh, 60, that's 2, 3, and 5.
Thanks!
You're welcome!
Hey, oh, hello,
Oh,
no,
dude,
one ticket.
No, go, just get off. Get off my bus!
Oh, don't you know who I am?
You're a drunk. I know what you are. I don't know who you are. I'll hear from you, as if. You'll hear from my lawyers. I don't think we will.
The door has been closed.
What?
St. Andrew's Church.
The heck is going on with these doors today? I think... I can't get to the bottom of that. I pressed the button to shut the door. Both the back one and the front one, but I've got a feeling... What? I've got a feeling if you do it in quick succession, it doesn't work. I don't know. I need to figure this one out. It does happen enough that I know there's something not right. Oh God. Did I just hear somebody throw up on my bus? Perfect stopping position. Is anybody getting on?
Good day. Regular single trip, please.
Okay, regular single. One trip, print. 80, and that's 5.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Senior single trip ticket, please.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You're most welcome, sir. Let's make sure the door's closed this time. Oh, okay. Why is my door not closing? I'm pressing the button here. Oh, I know. It's because I'm in this... That's so dumb. It won't let you open... You know what? I've got a feeling. Oh, man. It won't let you open and close doors while you're in a certain position. There we go. Yeah.
Oh, I can't get in without the ramp.
Oh, really, bro? You would you do this to me when I'm already late? Oh my god. I mean, no, it's fine, sir. Here you go.
I'm very grateful, sir.
You're welcome. I know you can map a button to this to do it from the cab, but I kind of like the personal touch. Yeah, I totally forgot that for some unknown reason, you can't operate the door if you're in any other camera position than this one right here. So if you go down to the ticket view, for example...
I can't feel my nose! Please turn up the heat!
Drama?
Stop, Village Street East.
How's that? The texture's... Did you see that? The texture was broken and it just loaded back in. Look at that. That is so weird. What was I saying? Yeah, if you're in the ticket view, you can't operate the doors. If you're in that up view where you're looking back, you can't adjust the doors. You can't do anything unless you're in this position. And it catches me out because I actually want to go in that up view, look back and see if the doors are open, but I can't. Oh well, at least we got here on time.
Village Street East.
Let's check all the doors opened. Yes, they did. Come on, get on the bus.
I can't get down like this.
One ticket regular.
Guy needs the ramp. Okay, one ticket regular. Let's get rid of these passengers first. And then we're gonna open the get the ramp down for this guy.
Have a great day.
You're welcome. Have a great day yourself. Okay, sir, we got you.
Sunny Springs needs more people like you.
Oh, thank you, sir. You're very kind. Now, in OMSI, you get kneeling buses and you get ramps and stuff like that, but you don't get passenger needs like that one. And that's definitely a plus one for this game. Also, I have become a victim of the AI in this. If you're making a turn and you don't quite make it, you'll find that the AI crowds around you and you're stuck. They don't move. They don't ever move. And then you end up hitting them. And if you hit them, you get fined. If you hit a person, it terminates the whole thing. It's brutal. Okay. Oh no, another wheelchair. Are you kidding me? Okay, let's deal with these guys. Or maybe we'll just go off there and... Are you getting on this one? What are you doing?
Deploy the ramp, please.
I am doing! Give me a break!
You have just become my favourite bus driver.
What? Because I did my job and deployed the ramp? How does that work? But yeah, that's very nice. Now, the question is, can I go straight on here? Is that a left turn, do you think? So, yeah, it looks like it is. I really don't want to hit anybody. There we go. We're good. You have just become my new favourite bus driver.
Next
oh, shucks.
Garden Lane.
Yeah, so I think I mentioned if you press the T key, it puts a speed limiter on. And that operates a button down on the dashboard there. If you see where the hazard warning red button is, it's the upper row, the left button. That's the speed limiter. You can turn it off if you're in a rush, but if you go through a speed camera, you get fined. But if you can, leave it on, I suggest, because it'll stop you from breaking the speed limit, which is very handy. Good morning.
Can I have a ticket, please?
Regular latte coming up. Okay, okay. 18.5.
Thank you, dear.
You're welcome. Yeah, so disabled passengers always travel free. So you don't need to worry about a ticket or anything.
Thank you. You are a godsend.
Really? Kind of overstating it a little bit. Well, at least she's grateful. Now, the way the sidewalks work, because I was talking to some people about this, because obviously we're set in kind of like Germany, and sidewalks kind of work differently, or level crossings, or zebra crossings, whatever you want to call them, they work differently. Not sidewalks. Yeah, pedestrian crossings, or zebra crossings as we call them in the UK. They work differently from country to country. Alright, let me do this stop and then I'll explain it. Because it's important to know how to deal with them in this country. Perfect stopping position. Has everybody got on and off? No. Late arriver. Look at that dodgy bloke there running. What's he running from, eh? So the way it works is, if I'm going straight like this, I have right of way. If I'm turning into another road, I do not have right of way. That's the simple way of remembering it. So if you're just driving along and there's a crossing, then that you should have right of way. Now that's not the same as the UK, because in the UK you always have to give way, regardless of whether you're turning or straight. You always have to stop. But here it seems to be a bit different. Gentian Street. Sounds a bit like Gentleman Street, except it's not. You've reached the end of the stop. Cool. Right, let's press enter. That's now locked in. Okay. That's now locked in, that one. Nice. We now have 252,000. Nice little chunk of XP there. Level 7. Unlocked a bus. Look at that. That means we can buy a new bus and a new driver. How convenient for us. Okay, so that's now done that, which is brilliant. Because now what we can do is we can assign... What's going on? Why's that got an exclamation mark on it? The route did not generate any income. Oh, yeah, well, yeah, it's fine. It wouldn't do, would it? So what we want to do now is assign a driver to that route, which I think they already are. Oh, did I mess up? Oh, yeah. Ina was already on the same route we were on. Fine, okay. So we'll leave her on that route. She's now driving that route because it's now validated. We'll now go to this route here, and we'll need to edit this because we need to create the second circuit. Let's collapse that a second. We've got West Street. So where's the starting position? There's one. Gentian Street. We don't really need that, if I'm honest. How are we going to create this circuit? We don't need that one. Because that's already covered. Okay, so one. Let's say we start here. Is that the best starting position? 1, 2. I don't think it is the best starting position. Oh, it doesn't matter. Yeah. Right, so if we start here. Let's say we start at the church, whatever. Rake Street, Crown, Rake. Then we loop back this way. And go to here. Now that's dumb. Let me just edit this out. Let's start in a different position. There we go. Let's start in Church Street, and then we'll go here, then here. That's what I want to do. That's better. And loop all the way back. That's it. That's the entire journey. Because they're the only... Oh, no, wait a sec. Yeah, that's fine. All the other blue stops, you can see the blue stops are the ones that belong to suburban district. So all the blue stops are now covered. So when we get to Rake Street, it'll be a drive back to Church Street West. That's the entire bus journey right there. So we'll save that. That's got all the blue dots done. They're all covered. We'll save that. And we'll drive it. Let's drive it in the same bus. No, let's tell you what. Because this is a 3-door. That's a 2-door. We'll just drive it in this one. That's fine. And then after that, Oh, holiday, great. Okay. Woo! Fantastic. Let's put the speed limiter on, let's release the brake, and off we go. So we'll go down to the first stop. Yeah, after this, we're going to create the third route. We'll then buy a bus, we'll buy the brand new bus. We'll drive that on the third route and get the other two taken care of by the drivers. And that should then tick all the boxes and level us up quite nicely. Did you see that passenger guy across the zebra crossing then? Pedestrian crossing. He almost walked into the bus. I've seen that happen as well. There are times when the pedestrians just walk into your bus and it just wrecks the whole journey. One regular trip, flipping it, look at the ticket sales. Oh my god. We are going to bring in a lot of money this time.
Thank you very much.
Come on, tourists, get on the bus.
Can I have a ticket, please?
Regular cappuccino.
Thank you, dear.
I need to purchase a ticket.
Senior single, you got that, bro. It's 2, 3, and 5. Everybody on the bus? Let's go. Awesome. Once you mapped a few buttons to like the parking, the kneeling, and then there's a button you can map to open all doors, I thoroughly recommend you map that one. Now here, I give way, okay? I've got to give way. Because I'm turning into this road. 16 seconds to get there. Flipping heck. I may just make it. Yes. Nice. Good morning.
Hello. Can you help me with a ticket?
Well, that's what I'm here for, so yeah. You'd think I'd be able to do that.
Thanks.
One ticket regular, please.
Another regular.
Thank you very much.
The only thing
can
about,
I have a ticket, please?
The only thing about this view is you can't see the passengers as well, which is slightly annoying.
Thanks. Have a great day.
Well, she's friendly. I like to be able to serve tickets and kind of look at the passenger, you know, but you can't do that because you have to go on that ticket view to operate the machine.
Next stop, St. Paul's Church.
Let's keep an eye out for this pedestrian here. There, you see that? That's a classic right there. That's a classic case of wipe out a pedestrian, end your journey. That guy ran across. It does do things like that, and I'm, you know.
What time is it?
At first it's really annoying, but then after a while you think, you know what, that's quite challenging, I like that.
I just don't want to make Mom mad again for being late.
We're never late. She's always too early.
Uh-huh, that old chestnut. And stop. Lots of people are going to get on the back though, look. Which is great.
A student day pass, please.
A student day pass? Have you got any ID, sir? Oh, man. Let's give you 80, bringing you up to 6, and then 8, 10.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Next time, bring some ID. Because you look about 54, mate. Hey, you never know. He could be an Open University student. Kind of getting the hang of the way the bus handles in this game now. Not hitting the curb so much. At first it used to catch me out with this game, but I'm kind of getting used to it. It's a little bit different to OMSI. Just double check for pedestrians. Just double check for everything, seriously. You get bendy buses later as well. You get like an MAM bendy
it's
bus.
So hot in here. Turn on the AC, please.
Jeez, bossy.
You like this shirt?
Yeah, it looks great. Where did you get it?
There's a really nice shop.
So that texture's not loaded again. How weird is that? And then we go to this view, we come back. You see, look at that. You can see the textures there, and then it just disappears. It's so weird. Okay, I don't think we've got that many stops left now. Yeah, I think it's all, if I remember the route, so just look at the route from the route editor. I think we've got like one or two stops and that's done. I think the trees are quite impressive in this game. A lot of the textures are not that impressive, but the trees are pretty good, actually. They actually look like they're filled out, you know, 3D. Anybody getting on? Is that somebody stood in the doorway? I think somebody stood in the doorway. Oh no. They're not, that's fine. Because we've not had that little chestnut for a bit. What's that menu do there? Nothing apparently.
Make sure to take all of your belongings with you before stepping off the bus.
Some nice cars kicking around this place. Not a piece of litter in sight either. Very clean town. Emergency services following us. I'll just pull over here and you can overtake. Flipping egg. That was a bit close. Everybody off! Come on, get out of here. Scoot. No, you can't stay on. Let's press enter, and we're done. Yay! Let's have a look how much money we got. Wow, that paid quite nicely, that one. Add revenue from the bus as well. Almost level 8. We have 259 still in the bank. I thought that would have gone up a bit more. We now have two active routes. Now, the last thing to do is have at least three different routes you and your drivers drove last week. Have all the bus stops be part of the routes driven by you. So, we've sorted out this one. The next thing to do is to buy a third bus and create a third route which picks up the rest of these. At which point, when we drive that route, we will complete all of these objectives. And don't forget there's a new bus model out, so we should be able to do that. But that's going to be in the next video. So I hope you enjoyed that one. Take care, guys. Until the next video, happy busing.